30 centimetres and live for as long as 7 years. And this body plan is so efficient that it's remained largely unchanged for hundreds of millions of years.
Evolution may be more intelligent than we thought, according to a University of Southampton professor. Professor Richard Watson says new research shows that evolution is able to learn from previous experience, which could provide a better explanation of how evolution by natural selection produces such apparently intelligent designs. By unifying the theory of evolution, which shows how random variation and selection is sufficient to provide incremental adaptation, with learning theories, which show how incremental adaptation is sufficient for a system to exhibit intelligent behavior, this research shows that it is possible for evolution to exhibit some of the same intelligent behaviors as learning systems, including neural networks. In an opinion paper, published in Trends in Ecology and Evolution, Professors Watson and Urs Zathmary, from the Parmenides Foundation in Munich, explain how formal analogies can be used to transfer specific models and results between the two theories to solve several important evolutionary puzzles. Professor Watson says, Darwin's theory of evolution describes the driving process, but learning theory is not just a different way of describing what Darwin already told us. It expands what we think evolution is capable of. It shows that natural selection is sufficient to produce significant features of intelligent problem solving. For example, a key feature of intelligence is an ability to anticipate behaviors that will lead to future benefits. Conventionally, evolution, being dependent on random variation, has been considered blind or at least myopic, unable to exhibit such anticipation. But showing that evolving systems can learn from past experience means that evolution has the potential to anticipate what is needed to adapt to future environments in the same way that learning systems do. When we look at the amazing, apparently intelligent designs that evolution produces, it takes some imagination to understand how random variation and selection produced them. Sure, given suitable variation and suitable selection, and we also need suitable inheritance, then we're fine. But can natural selection explain the suitability of its own processes? That self-referential notion is troubling to conventional evolutionary theory, but easy in learning theory. Learning theory enables us to formalize how evolution changes its own processes over evolutionary time. For example, by evolving the organization of development that controls variation, the organization of ecological interactions that control selection, or the structure of reproductive relationships that control inheritance, natural selection can change its own ability to evolve. If evolution can learn from experience, and thus improve its own ability to evolve over time, this can demystify the awesomeness of the designs that evolution produces. Natural selection can accumulate knowledge that enables it to evolve smarter. That's exciting because it explains why biological design appears to be so intelligent.
Dr. Bunsen Honeydew, here at Muppet Labs, where the future is being made today. Well, jeepers, you're about to witness the world's first demonstration of fireproof paper. Here is my assistant Beaker carrying a lighted blowtorch. He will now show you how impossible it is to ignite the fireproof paper in this basket. There is no way this paper can burn. With Muppet's fireproof paper, you'll always feel secure. Tune in next time and witness Muppet Lab's new answer to the energy crisis, flammable water. That's all for now from Muppet Labs. Oh dear.
Charles Darwin's theory of evolution offers an explanation for why biological organisms seem so well designed to live on our planet. This process is typically described as unintelligent, based on random variations with no direction. But despite its success, some oppose this theory because they don't believe living things can evolve in increments. Something as complex as the eye of an animal, they argue, must be the product of an intelligent creator. I don't think invoking a supernatural creator can ever be a scientifically useful explanation. But what about intelligence that isn't supernatural? Our new results, based on computer modeling, link evolutionary processes to the principles of learning and intelligent problem solving, without involving any higher powers. This suggests that, although evolution may have started off blind, with a couple of billion years of experience, it has got smarter. What is intelligence? Intelligence can be many things, but sometimes it's nothing more than looking at a problem from the right angle. Finding an intelligent solution can be just about recognizing that something you assume to be a constant might be variable, like the orientation of the paper in the image below. It can also be about approaching a problem with the right building blocks. With good building blocks, for example triangles, it's easy to find a combination of steps, folds, that solves the problem by incremental improvement. Each fold covers more picture. But with bad building blocks, folds that create long thin rectangles, a complete solution is impossible. In humans, the ability to approach a problem with an appropriate set of building blocks comes from experience, because we learn. But until now we have believed that evolution by natural selection can't learn. It simply plods on, banging away relentlessly with the same random variation hammer, incrementally accumulating changes when they happen to be beneficial. The evolution of evolvability. In computer science, we use algorithms, such as those modeling neural networks in the brain, to understand how learning works. Learning isn't intrinsically mysterious. We can get machines to do it with step-by-step algorithms. Such machine learning algorithms are a well-understood part of artificial intelligence. In a neural network, learning involves adjusting the connections between neurons, stronger or weaker, in the direction that maximizes rewards. With simple methods like this, it is possible to get neural networks to not just solve problems, but to get better at solving problems over time. But what about evolution? Can it get better at evolving over time? The idea is known as the evolution of evolvability. Evolvability, simply the ability to evolve, depends on appropriate variation, selection and heredity, Darwin's cornerstones. Interestingly, all of these components can be altered by past evolution, meaning past evolution can change the way that future evolution operates. For example, random genetic variation can make a limb of an animal longer or shorter, but it can also change whether forelimbs and hind limbs change independently or in a correlated manner. Such changes alter the building blocks available to future evolution. If past selection has shaped these building blocks well, it can make solving new problems look easy, easy enough to solve with incremental improvement. For example, if limb lengths have evolved to change independently, evolving increased height will require multiple changes, affecting each limb, and intermediate stages may be worse off. But if changes are correlated, individual changes might be beneficial. The idea of the evolution of evolvability has been around for some time. Our work shows that the evolution of regulatory connections between genes, which govern how genes are expressed in our cells, has the same learning capabilities as neural networks. In other words, gene networks evolve like neural networks learn, while connections in neural networks change in the direction that maximizes rewards. Natural selection changes genetic connections in the direction that increases fitness. The ability to learn is not itself something that needs to be designed. It is an inevitable product of random variation and selection when acting on connections. The exciting implication of this is that evolution can evolve to get better at evolving in exactly the same way that the neural network can learn to be a better problem solver with experience. The intelligent bit is not explicit, thinking ahead, or anything else un-Darwinian. It is the evolution of connections that allow it to solve new problems without looking ahead. So, when an evolutionary task we guessed would be difficult, such as producing the eye, turns out to be possible with incremental improvement, instead of concluding that dumb evolution was sufficient after all, we might recognize that evolution was very smart to have found building blocks that make the problem look so easy. Interestingly, Alfred Russel Wallace, who suggested a theory of natural selection at the same time as Darwin, later used the term intelligent evolution to argue for divine intervention in the trajectory of evolutionary processes. If the formal link between learning and evolution continues to expand, the same term could become used to imply the opposite.
Welcome again to Muppet Labs, where the future is being made today. Dr. Bunsen Honeydew here with news to set you a quiver. Beaker, dear lad, come over here. Oh, Beaker, you forgot the beaker. Now, get the beaker, Beaker. Go on. You are about to see the first sample ever isolated of the new element, bunsonium, contained in this selfsame beaker here. So far, we have found no use for bunsonium. We already know that it does not remove paint, it isn't a good glue, and when used as a shampoo, it produces unusual side effects. Right, Beaker? So today, we begin an experiment to see what bunsonium does when taken internally. My assistant, Beaker, here, will now drink the bunsonium. Oh, that's all right. There, Beaker. Just take a teensy little sip at first, and remember not to get carried away and gulp the whole thing. Go ahead. It's all right. Go on. Good. And now, in just a few moments, we shall know exactly what bunsonium does. Oh, so that's what bunsonium does. Come, Beaker, let's go find a bicycle pump and pump you back up.